The clubs now, you get a man, they don't even ask you to dance, they just come in and pull you. Hey, that's bad. Nah. And we also take care of our kids, we have kids. We deal with the same stress as men. So when it comes to 10 o'clock at night, we ain't trying to get over and have no sex. But hey, wait a minute, let me get some rest. And maybe in the morning time,
maybe I'll be able to go. Before you go.
I know, so I mean, you know, because I'm tired.
My sleep is priceless.
Yeah, I'm tired. In the morning, time know, about 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, I'm good to go.
But I think time wouldn't really matter.
If you were in love, if like
you,
that,
and you have that romance, if you work all day and I come home to my children, but if my man has, I have that excitement and I'm feeling him, we can go in the bathroom.
Exactly.
So just to hit a wall. But it has to be, I have to feel you. You know, I have
that
to know.
Chemistry
it has to be reciprocated.
Yeah. If it's not there, then you can be like, shit.
Nah, catch me.
That's a non-stress man.
Yes.
If he can't see that you've worked 40 hours a week and you come home and you've got your children, and then you want to deal, and then you have to satisfy him. Mm-hmm. Not alone cook his supper, but to satisfy him on top of this.
I know, that's overtime.
You know, that's just how
and then you split the bills in half? Ha.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. Men understand that you split it in half like y'all roommates.
Why can't you step up and say, okay, let me meet her halfway. Let me do A, B, and C. And then, so I can get D.
That's right.
Why can't the man do that? Why can't he meet? Why are they so selfish?
But back again
to that point.
But back again, we have to teach our boys
how to be men.
They don't know. Not like what 85% of our households are led by women.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. They don't know.
In the church.
They don't know.
I mean, talk about the preachers praying on a women.
So basically, when we see our men boys running out here from woman to woman,
they're trying to find themselves.
But you know what? It's a shame because they live like that until they're 50 years old.
Oh, longer
than that.
I said at least
50 years old. So when do they grow?
Some grow and some don't.
They grow when
that's scary.
Real women stop letting them be the way they are and make them be real men. Mm-hmm. Stop giving them that attention and things like that when they're little boys trying to be men.
But unfortunately, but unfortunately, it's a double-edged sword because we have not only little boys growing up without men, we have little girls growing up without men.
Yeah.
So all they want is a man.
And whatever that means will never eliminate it. And those are our women these days
who say, you know, I just want somebody in my bed. He feels that void.
But when did this start men wanting women to take care of them? When did that shit start?
I don't know where that shit started. Was somebody letting me know?
Men chasing a woman. Mm-hmm. The chase is always over. Oh, I got her now. Okay. Well, what happened to the dates and all of that? You have to still court, but you want me to court you.
It's they don't have the male role models to teach them how to be men, as Tara said.
But why can't men step up and say, okay, I'm not happy with what I have, you know, or what I'm getting.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Why can't they fix themselves? I mean, why we have to fix them?
Because they don't think it's them.
I don't want to take on a science project because that's what they
I understand that. I know that's right.
Science project. You know, so what? Your mama, your daddy, whoever passed away when you was a child.
I agree.
You know, get therapy.
Exactly.
Why I have to tell you to get therapy?
Well, if you had seven relationships
and they all ended the same way. It's not the women, it's you. Mm-hmm. Get therapy, see what the hell is wrong with you, and fix it. Why let some other get involved with another woman and let them take on this and expect them to take on a science project? Because that is what they are.
But then we have women who take on those science projects.
They're happy to.
They take care of the man. They paying all the bills. He don't have to work. He works when he wants. I mean, what is up with
but
that?
But they don't let
what
them
kind
know.
Of a man would do that?
I will let them know you're a science project and you cannot go
low self-esteem for the woman that's
but nine times out of
absolutely.
Ten.
Yes. Absolutely.
Woman with that
but that's why the men are like that these days.
Yvette was saying, we as women, why do we allow this?
Yes, exactly.
Just, I mean, it's that ratio. I know we were on the most college campus, about 10,000 students, and it was like a 9-to-1 ratio of men to women. I mean, women to men. And so when you have those odds, men think they can do anything, basically. You know, if you won't take me, well, I know she will, and she will. I have 8 more choices. And so, I mean, that's what we have to deal with.
Why can't men talk to their women about what it is that they want? Why do they go outside their household and
talk to other, talk to other females?
She said it was back to the cowboy part, the stuff.
No, no, no. Why do you have to go to another female?
Dallas Cowboy.
Oh,
I love to go to sports bars. I meet a lot of men. And because I can talk freely and I go out and drink, they think that I'm different from their wives. No, I'm not different. I want the same thing their wives want, but I'm not going to bicker back and forth because you ain't my man. But if we're in a relationship, I would expect the same thing from them. And so they think, men think when they move, they think the grass is always greener on the other side. But it's not greener. It's not different. You know, so men just don't like to communicate. They think they want to go where the road is easier.
And I get confused sometimes because I don't know if men want a submissive woman or do they want an aggressive woman? Do they want this independent woman who can stand on their feet and they can grow together? Or do they want a woman that will just sit back and say, when I talk, you listen, and you do as I say? Mm-hmm. I get so confused in my relationship now because I'm like, okay, now you want me to speak up, but when I speak up, you can't take it when I'm spitting out. Now, what do you want?
They want a Chinese chick.
Well, I take a shout out.
Here's another question. Why do men think women don't want a man? Why do men think black women don't want a man or don't need a man?
They don't need a man.
That's
how basic. A lot of women say that, but I understand why they say that.
No, no, no. They're not saying they don't need a man.
Right.
They're saying they don't need
it's
a
drama.
Bullshit.
That's right. Exactly.
To the table.
We want a good man. We don't want any man.
Exactly. We don't want a science project.
Exactly. That pisses me off very much. Yes.
We're not saying we don't need a man, and for a black man to ask a white woman, why do they say this to their race, to their men? It's ridiculous.
Yeah,
because
I find that offensive.
White men are nowhere near.
That's your cushion. Fuck.
Exactly.
Okay, a lot of us grew up parentless or with one parent missing from the home. Be a man. You're grown
up
now. You already had these kids. Man up. You want us to woman up? You want us to cook, clean, fuck you? Man up. Pay the bills.
I know. That's
pay
what
the
saying.
Damn bills.
On time.
You want us to be a superwoman. Be a superwoman. You gotta be superman with
me. Let me tell you about the realtor. One of my friends is a realtor, big realtor in the Washington metropolitan area. And she indicates that when men and women come, married people come to the table to get ready to buy a house, the man's credit is jacked the fuck up. They can't get shit but an Eastern Motor Car. And that's all they got. 30 days, your job's your credit. And I understand about, you know, that, you know, a black man in terms of being consistent with working, you know, getting up every day, going to their job. Thinking about retirement, thinking about vacations, thinking about education for your children,
exactly.
Thinking about you want a better life for your kids than you had. Mm-hmm. I don't understand why men don't think that far ahead in advance.
That's selfish.
Thinking about family.
Mm-hmm.
White folks think about wealth.
Yeah.
You know, building. Making
sure
that their family has something better. Not living in front of having an apartment and driving a $50,000 car.
Right.
I don't understand that concept. But I met this guy. I was like, why do you have an expedition if you live a damn apartment and you work a job, you know, hourly, got your name on your shirt. And I don't mind working with a blue collar brother, but you mean what are you doing?
Working
you have two kids. What are your plans?
Right.
So I can't, you know, I don't think that black men plan for the future. Let's plan. How are we gonna get to A, B, and C, and D?
But so, if they're never taught, ladies.
But there is so much education out here for them to get.
No,
there's so much.
Mama is just happy that boy is not in jail.
Yeah.
Well, that's the problem.
Boy is not in jail, baby. She got
who did you say, mama? That's the problem. It's a whole lot of mama boys out here. It's a whole lot of mama voice. That's one of the problems.
Not only that, too. I mean, you have these women. If you're dealing with this man and you know his credit is jacked up, and you know this nigga is using you to get something in your name for him.
Do you know up front that his credit is jacked up?
He's asking you to get a cell phone in his name. This nigga can't get a cell phone.
Now, you know who can't get that now?
A car. Why do I have to co-sign with you?
But you meet them all the time at the club.
Women need to look at the difference when the man say, a woman is always walking around here saying they don't need a man. When black men needs to understand something. When a woman says she don't need a man, it's because I can stand by myself. I want a man.
Yeah.
When you need somebody, means you can't stand alone.
That's right.
And there's a difference.
Grow with you.
I don't want somebody to need me. I want somebody to want me.
That's
I want
right.
to want you. I don't want to need you.
That's right.
And that's why I think that, in terms of, I can work with a brother. I don't mind us working together. Where I'm at weak, you can be strong. If I'm better at finances, and you're better at fixing the house, then let's work together to build something as a family so that when we leave off this earth, our children can say, hey, this is what my mom and pops left me so that I can have a better life for their grandkids. Mm-hmm. So that's all I'm saying. Let's work together. And sometimes black men can't see that. They think about going with their boys, do this, and that, and the other, but I take care of home. They should be taken care of.